Hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessings and glory from Almighty God. Praises and adoration. We exalt his holy name, glory to God. He is God all by himself. He is so powerful. He's just so amazing. He is just so awesome. All we need to do is just to learn how to totally, totally trust him. Glory be to God. You have tuned into Midday Glory. I'm Reverend Gwendolyn Dixon, and I will be your host for the next 20 minutes. And as we have begun this new year, we must realize that there is absolutely nothing new under the sun. The God that we serve is the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. The Bible is the same. It does not change. Many translations have been presented, but it's still from Genesis to Revelation. There are 39 books in the Old Testament, and there are 27 books in the New Testament. If you find that there is a difference, let it go, because it is not the word of God. If I was to use for a topic today, it would be, what do God expect of us? In the word of God, it requires that we love one another. The word of God requires that we pray for one another. The word of God requires that we forgive one another. It also requires that we love our enemies, that we study his word, that we be doers of his word. As we watch as well as pray, we realize how the world is changing. But the God that we serve do not change. We must know that all believers must be steadfast. We must be unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. As believers in Christ, there should be a standard that must be followed as we as believers. We can't be like the world. We cannot change with the world. We cannot make things convenient for the world. We must be different. 1 Peter 2:9 says that we are a chosen generation. We are a royal priesthood and holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Glory be to God. And I just want to take a moment to look at this word, peculiar people. The phrase comes from the King James Version, and it's not really seen in the more modern translations today. But as I said, the word of God does not change. During the time the King James was translated, the word peculiar was often used to refer to something belonging to someone, as in someone's property. If we look up the word peculiar in a dictionary today, we will still see that is one of the several meanings this word can have. Probably the most common usage of the word peculiar today is referring to someone or something that is strange, odd, or uncommon. Yet alternative meanings in the dictionary still tell us that this word can be used to describe something or someone that belongs exclusively to some person or group or thing, or to refer to a property or privilege that belongs exclusively or characteristically to a person. The original meaning of the Greek words translated peculiar in 1 Peter 2:9 is indeed what is meant in this passage. In this verse of Scripture, Peter is not saying that Christians are odd or unusual people, even though the world says that we are all the time, glory to God. What this passage is communicating is that Christians or believers are people who belong to God, hallelujah. We are his own possession. Another way of saying it is that we, believers, are God's own special people, hallelujah. Everything that we need is right in the word of God, glory be to God. The word teaches us to love one another. St. John 13, verses 34-35 says, "A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another. By this shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if you have loved one to another." And then the word of God also teaches us to love our enemies. And I have found this to be one of my favorite scriptures, Matthew 5:44. "But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. And then the word of God teaches us to pray one for another. James 5:16 says, confess your faults one to another and pray for one another that ye may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Then the word of God also teaches us to forgive. Ephesians 4:32, and be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. Glory be to God. You see, when we don't abide by the word of God, there are consequences. And I want to share with you in Matthew 18 about if we don't forgive and what can happen to us. Okay, so the story, everybody knows the story that Peter said to the Lord, how often should he forgive his brother and let him continue on sinning against him? And Peter said, should it be just seven times? But the Lord said, no, don't say seven. I said until 70 times seven. Therefore is the kingdom of heaven likened unto a certain king, which would take account of his servants. And what he had begun to reckon, one was brought unto him, which owed him 10,000 talents. But as far as he had not to pay, his Lord commanded that he be sold, that his wife be sold, and his children, all that he had, and payment to be made. But the servant fell down and he began to worship the Lord. He began to ask the Lord to have patience with him and that he would pay him. And the Lord, being who he is, had compassion upon this servant. So he loosened him and he forgave him of all of his debt. But that same servant went out and found one of his fellow servants, which owed him only 100 pence. And he laid hands on him and took him by the throat, saying, pay me that thou owest me. And his servant did the same thing he did. He fell at his servant's feet and besought him and said, have patience with me and I will pay you. But that servant would not. He went and he cast him into prison till he should pay the debt. So when his fellow servants saw what he had done, they were very sorrowful. So they came and they told the Lord all that would happen. Then the Lord said, is this the same man that I forgave? So he called him back to him. He said, thou wicked servant, I forgave thee all that thou did because thou desirest me. Shouldest thou not also have compassion on thy fellow servant, even as I have pity on thee? And his Lord was wroth and delivered him to the tormentors, that he should pay all that was due unto him. So likewise shall our heavenly Father do also unto us, if we from our hearts forgive not everyone his brother their trespasses. Glory be to God. You see, the word of God does not play. We must adhere to the word of God. We must abide in his word. Then the word of God also teaches us to be doers of his word. James 1, starting at 22 says, But be ye doers of the word, and not just hearers only, deceiving your own selves. For if any man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, and straighteneth forgotten what manner of man he was. But whosoever looketh in the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deeds. Glory be to God. And then the word of God speaks of the last and the evil days. And if we really know the word of God and we really abide in the Lord, we know that we see that we are living in the last and evil days. 2 Timothy 3 says, this show also that in the last days, perilous times shall come, for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, and unthankful and unholy, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, for such turn away. Then the word of God also speaks about false prophets. And Matthew 7:15 says, beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are raving wolves. All the above, every scripture that the Lord has given to us today is a warning from God. When we have a true relationship with God, when we are connected, when we are doers of his word, when we are loving our enemies, when we are forgiving people, the word of God just flows through us, and we just have that deep desire to continue doing his will. Glory to God. As we are doers of the word, we must abide and in him as he in nothing. John 15 tells us that abide in me. This is the Lord speaking, abide in me as I in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine. No more can ye, except ye abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. But without me, you can do absolutely nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered. And men gather them and cast them into the fire as they are burned. My God, glory to God. It is a joy in serving God. Hallelujah. When we give up ourselves and we just make God first in our lives, it is such a joy in serving. When we put all of our trust in him, when we seek him with our whole heart, glory be to God, there is peace that surpasses all understanding. Serving God is a blessing from on high. When we humble ourselves before our God, wait on him, and let the Lord fight our battles every single time, the victory will be ours. We serve a mighty good God. He has given us everything that pertains to life and godliness. It's nothing that he will not do for us. He loves us unconditionally. All power is in his hand. The word of God tells us that we have to, that all we have to do is to seek him. When we search for him with our whole heart, glory to God, just let God do it. Hallelujah. We don't try to do things on our own. Just let God do it. Study his word, and everything that we need is in the word of God. Glory. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, almighty God, you are the everlasting Father. You are God. We bless your name, God, on this midday hour. We praise you, almighty God, and we exhort you because you are our Father, which art in heaven. You are our Master, glory to God. You are our Redeemer, hallelujah. You are our high tower, hallelujah. There is no one like you, almighty God, on all this earth. We honor you, and we bow down on this midday hour, almighty God, before you. You are the great I am, hallelujah. You are the beginning, almighty God. Mighty God, and you are the end. You are the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. There is no one like you, almighty God. You are worthy, hallelujah, to be praised, Lord God. As we look at our day thus far, Lord God, when you woke us up this morning, God, you were worthy to be praised, God. When you provided breakfast for us to feed our families, God, you are worthy to be praised, Lord God. You provided transportation that we could get to our destinations today, God. You are worthy to be praised, God. You woke us up in our right minds, almighty God. You are worthy to be praised, God. We thank you, Lord God, for excellent health, God. We praise you, almighty God. We desire to praise you, Lord God. We desire, almighty God, to worship you, God. We have learned you, Father God, through your word, God, through your power, through your actions, Lord God. And we know, God, that you are worthy, Lord God. You have given us everything, Lord God. You have given us so much, Lord God. And we just want you to know, God, we appreciate you, Lord God. Father God, in the midst of the storms and trials and tribulations, God, you have been right with us, God. You've calmed all of our fears, God. You've calmed all of our anxieties, almighty God. You've wiped away our tears, God. You've given us joy and you've given us peace. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You are so very special to us, Lord God. You are so unique and you are so different, Lord God. You were born of a Virgin Mary. Hallelujah. You walked this earth for just 3 years, God, but those 3 years was all power, mighty power, glory to God. You were obedient to your Father, hallelujah. God, you were crucified. You were beaten 40 excruciating lashes over your body, Lord God. Your flesh, almighty God, fell from your bones, Lord God. A crown was placed around your head, and blood, almighty God, came streaming down, Lord God. But that blood, hallelujah, gave us a right to the tree of life, and we praise you today, Lord God. We thank you for the blood, Lord God. We thank you, almighty God, for the sacrifice, Lord God. We thank you, almighty God, for being obedient even unto death. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We bow down before you in humble submission today, Lord God. We surrender ourselves, almighty God, to you. Hallelujah. We thank you for loving us unconditionally, almighty God. There is no one on this earth, oh God, that would do for us what you have done for us, Lord God. No one would give up their life. Nobody, almighty God, would take 49 excruciating lashes, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah, Lord God. Lord God, you were lied on. You were spit on. You were disrespect, but yet, Father God, you did not try to defend yourself. You remained quiet, Lord God, because you knew everything that you was doing, God, that there was going to be, there was a reason behind it, Lord God. Father, God, we thank you for being obedient and following your Father's instructions, Almighty God. You, Almighty God, that is our God. Hallelujah. We seek you, Father God, earnestly, Lord God. We thirst for you, Lord God, hallelujah, because we know we can do nothing without you, Almighty God. Oh, Lord God, we cry out today that we would ask for the forgiveness of our sins, Lord God, and that you would cleanse us and deliver us, Lord God, and set us free from the enemy's camp in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We know that the enemy comes to sift us like wheat, Lord God, but you came, oh God, that you would give us life, God, hallelujah. We cry out, Lord God, that we want to be more like you, Lord God. We want, Father God, to distribute your attributes and your characteristics in our lives, Lord God. We desire, Almighty God, to be doers of your word. We desire to be a light in darkness in the name of Jesus, God. For you are the Christ, Lord God, and we salute you today, Almighty God. We pray, Father God, for every believer today, Lord God, as we see Father God, the tour sometimes that we have to go through, Lord God, as we see, God, that we are living in the last and easy days, and it's a test for us, Lord God, but we know, God, that we must stay. We know, God, that we must remain in you, Lord God. We must be strong and powerful in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We must, Father God, be active in your word, Lord God. We will not be tossed by every wind of doctrine, Lord God, hallelujah, but God, we will stand strong, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Glory to God, hallelujah. We stand firm on your Lord, your word, oh God. We must know you for ourselves, hallelujah. Father God, we pray to be strong and mighty in you, oh God. We pray, God, that we will exercise faith, God. We will exercise trust and belief in you, Almighty God. We pray today, God, Father God, for the government employees who are furloughed, Lord God. The government, Father God, is partially shut down, God, and even some of those that are working, God, will not get paid. But we pray, God, that the believers that are in the midst of all of this, God, that this is when they will exercise their trust and their belief in you, God. They will know, God, that you will never leave them nor forsake them. Glory to God. Hallelujah. They will know and believe, Almighty God, that you supply all of their needs according to your riches in glory. Hallelujah. We, Father God, believe, hallelujah, and trust, oh Lord God, that you have already provided us everything. Hallelujah. We must believe that you will not, Father God, allow us to go hungry. You will not allow anyone to be naked, Lord God. You will not allow anyone to be put out of their homes, oh God, because they cannot pay their mortgage because of this fear, Lord God. We thank you that we decree and declare that you are our provider, Lord God, that you are our wheel in the middle of a wheel, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God. You are our bright and morning star, Lord God. Oh God, we praise you through all of this, Lord God, because we know that you are God that sits high and look, Lord, and you see everything, God. We exercise this time, Lord God, that time, God, that the furlough employees, God, have, Lord God, that they would exercise this time, Almighty God, to get closer to you, to get closer in your word, God, to lengthen their quiet time, that they may be rushing in the mornings, Father God, to get to work, Lord God, that they, Father God, will be witness to those who do not know you in the pardon of sin. We all will be witnesses, Lord God, and that we, Father God, will, Father God, help to see the people through this time right now, Lord God, in the name of you, God, that we will not accept being frightened or feared or anything or anxiety or stress, Father God, in the name of Jesus, God. You, Father God, have already orchestrated everything, Lord God. And we know, God, everything that happens around us, God, that you are God that makes no mistakes. You know all things because you are our God, Lord God. You are omnipotent, God. All power is in your hands, God. You are omniscient, Lord God. You're the all-knowing and the all-wise, God. You're the very present, God, Lord God. You are God, hallelujah. All power is in your hands. You control this universe, glory to God. As believers, we must believe. We must have faith, God. No matter what the situation looks like, we put all of our trust in you, Father God, through this process in the name of Jesus, God. We've learned through your word that we will go through trials and tribulations, oh God. But if we go, Father God, that we are anchored in you, oh God, hallelujah. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, that we will come out as true, oh God, as long as we put our focus on you, Lord God. We choose to trust you, Almighty God. We choose to pray for one another, Lord God. We choose to love one another, Lord God, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. We give glory and honor
and peace, hallelujah, to your name. We know that you would never see the righteous forsaken, nor the seed bearing breaking bread. We trust you, Almighty God. On this day, God, when Christians speak talk radio, midday glory, oh God, continue, Almighty God, to pray without ceasing, God. We pray for the sick, Father God. We pray, Father God, for families, oh Lord God, losing loved ones from senseless acts, oh God, that we see on the news, God, that we hear, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, for these bereaved families, Lord God. We thank you, God, and we pray for the government, Lord God. We pray for Donald Trump in the White House, oh God, and all those associated with the House of Representatives, the House, the Senate, and all of those people, Lord God. We pray today, God, for police officers, Lord God, and its associates. We pray, Almighty God, for school teachers and all that are involved in education in the name of Jesus, God. We pray for doctors, we pray for lawyers, we pray for nurses, oh God, in the name of Jesus, God. We pray earnestly for this entire world, Lord God, that Father God, whatever we do, God, wherever we go, God, we will let your light shine on the inside of us, God. Continue to humble us, oh God, that we may be used by you, Lord God. And this is your servant's prayer in the name of the Father, Son, and the blessed Holy Spirit. We say amen, amen, and amen. Let's continue to always think, what do God expect of us? And let us act out what God expects of us. Blessings to all that we're hearing now and we'll hear later on after they turn back to the number. Thank you so much. God bless you richly. Bye-bye.